Thank you. Actually, by the way, we use all Las Vegas.
Yeah, so, of course, if we talk about then, we walk from here, but. So, what we thought, one of my, well, by the way, I need to thank a few people here, so I want to thank particularly the faculty research grant here at Texas State for sponsoring me. This actually project started in 2020 during the pandemic, and it's completely stopped for a while, and I cannot perform anywhere. But I was able to kind of sneak in and go to California and get this. It's actually a replica of a violoncello piccolo. It's a Chinese made, but it's a really beautiful instrument. Practice it and get to learn it and to play this concert. So, you know, the project, one of the aims achieved the first piece, you know, looking at the composer's music at the composer's, you know, time, the context, you know. But actually, while old music, you know, become, you know, new, you know, when we play that game, new music can become old as well. So it's kind of that old and new kind of, you know, overlapping that I'm very interested, very curious about it. So I commissioned two composers to write music for this instrument, like new music, because, well, you know, the old instrument, you know, don't just play those pieces that, and unfortunately this instrument wasn't well used after, for a while, during the classical and romantic period. So, well, maybe we can create new music for it. So the first piece we're going to do is Jennifer Baylor, composer from, professor from UNLV, University of Nevada, Las Vegas, wrote this piece, Densify Prelude. And by the way, after that, there'll be a short break. We're going to go back from stuff, but it's not going to be a long audition, so stay around. We've got nice music in the second half, too. But here is Densify Prelude by Jennifer Baylor.
Thank you.
5 to 7 minutes.
Thank you.
Besides this piece, I also transcribed some of the violin music and other pieces. And thanks everybody for coming. Maybe I'll let Jonathan talk a little bit about the forte piano, since everybody must be curious about this instrument real quick. And then we'll begin with Schubert Passion Sonata.
This piano was built by a man named Paul McNulty in the Czech Republic. He's an American who lives in the Czech Republic. And when you ask him why he lives there, he says so that he can build pianos and afford to eat. It's a copy of an 1805 piano by the firm of Anton Walter und Sohn, who were a piano building firm that were most famous for being Beethoven's famous favorite piano builders in Vienna. What people know about the forte piano, if you know about the forte piano, is that it changed drastically every 10 years or so. There are huge changes that take place. This is an 1805 style piano, so it's really appropriate for music up through middle period Beethoven. Most of Beethoven's middle period sonatas fit nicely on it. By the time Schubert was writing the Arpeggione Sonata in 1824, this was a really old-fashioned piano. However, one thing that scholars have pointed out about Schubert's music is that it often uses a really small range compared to what was available at the time. The assumption seeming to be that Schubert, quite poor, probably borrowed old hand-me-down pianos or bought older pianos, and may well actually have had a piano kind of like this one, a 20-year-old or so piano that was the old model, kind of like an old used car. And I think this piece actually fits quite nicely on this instrument, and it balances very nicely with Kawai's piano. After the concert, you're welcome to come up and take a look at the piano and play it. You'll notice that it doesn't have foot pedals, but it does have some other mechanisms that you can come and play. play with. And you'll see that the hammers face exactly the opposite direction from modern pianos. So it's a much simpler mechanism with many less moving parts. And if anybody feels strong, you could stick around and help us load it up in the vehicle after the concert. You laugh, but I'm serious.
Think about my muscles.
I have no idea how to turn this off.
Thank you.